And now, it's assuming you've constructed this campus. So my question, my channel, I don't want to talk like my brother, because he has the co-position of Secretary General. So Ghana is telling us that I will deliver. So for the 1 year that has been there, why has he been attending this call?
It's a student council project. We have, please stand up. That's ahead of us. Amen. And he's a member of the student council. So to answer your question,
if I can
live by what I said, yes, I mean, less than 6 months. Of course, it's workable. Service to the students. All you want to do is serve the students. Like I said, in the swimming pool area, cannot happen in a year. That guys go for swimming for free. If they are an activity fee of 1,000 shillings, which we do not know what it's for. So here I am, ladies and gentlemen. We also have the transport services. We want the whole system to be taken back, whereby guys can leave campus at 1, guys can leave campus at 3:30, guys can leave campus at 6:45. We don't want students to have a situation where your class ends at 11 and you have to wait for the 4:30 bus. It doesn't make sense. We also have to have value for our time. Any other questions?
What I wanted to know, want to answer whether or not you can deliver, is what the administration has done in the past to lead you to believe that they will cooperate with you, Mr. That's all.
What the administration has done in the past to let me believe that
they will cooperate with you, Mr. Yes.
I stand here as a current director of the Cultural Week. I experienced a hard time. We experienced, as a mighty, we experienced a hard time making the Cultural Week happen. So it took us to work very, very, very well with the administration in looking for sponsorships together, and also asking them to give us to add money for the Cultural Week budget, and which they helped us, and I also believe in them that we can work together to have to make my vision for the school true.
We are sharing ideas here. It's not an argument, or it's not a place where you can say ignorance. I'm going to ask a question. First, I would like to know, I'm actually giving you this opportunity to tell us, most of you, actually the three of you, have previously served in the student council. So what have you done? And what is with your engagement on student policy? I mean, you're serving the students. Have you engaged with the students in the things that you intend to do? So, or you're just going with your team and agreeing that this is what you need to do, and you've not consulted the students and indeed known whether this is what the students want? Please do tell us. And maybe this time we can start with Kitaka.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. I have been taking part in student activities right before the member of the student council. We had the CBA guys with you for the first time. We were able to secure a spot of three guys, me, Rogers, and a guy called Nelson Mutua, where we engaged in activities and we won a 100% package. That's why you see them here this year, due to our discipline, due to our work ethic. That's why we won African American University again. In my time, I say again, I was director of the Cultural Committee, whereby that is a very, very, very daunting position. Because you really have to engage with sponsors, you really have to make things happen for the students. And that's why I believe that I should be the next president of African Nazarene University due to the past experiences and the relationships I was able to come up with from the previous sponsors. Thank you.
In the outgoing council, I've been serving as social affairs director, and I've been so much involved in a number of things, accommodation, health services, catering, transport, security. So I want to talk about something about security. For those students who are here during the start of the year, remember that when we came, there's an email that we didn't have. For some reason, there's no bus that's going to Tamkan Park, there's no bus. The bus that's going to Tamkan Park was increased from 25 to 44. So in that time when I came, we did the work with the student president because that's my work. Okay. So a number of times that we had a number of meetings pushing, engaging the administration so that they can subsidize the price at that time. So much negotiation, even making the list, you guys said so that the price was reduced from 40, so at least something. Then at concerning the campus bus, I know there's still a problem because sometimes that we used to, as long as you have a classic on campus, you just need to go to academic advisor sign for you, so then you are not paying even a single cent. But after that, after the bus is withdrawn, negotiation, after so much negotiation, it was brought back. Now we have to say, so because that was involved a number of economies and situations, according to the administration, they were running short of money, so we had no other way. So I want to say that I was pushed for those things. Then concerning accommodations, the Nazarene the time that we've been having problems concerning hot water in the hostels, most of the time, personal chairs, okay, we work there, but now, whenever things seem to really lag behind, I can go to the manager so that things can work and make sure that things are working effectively. So far, that's it.
You people are studying in front of you to convince you to vote for them. And they convince you by building good arguments for them. And they give arguments that are convincing to elect for them. Back to the question, how I am the secretary of the student council president. And on Friday I'll be the next president of the university. Not as I would be the secretary, but the next president of A in the circle. What have I done as secretary? My brother Kitaka was chairing the committee of Cultural Week, and I was the secretary of the council. I was being able to conduct all the meetings, organize all the meetings for him to be present to lead. I was being able to look for bus, make us sit down for him to be able to eat. That's how the Cultural Week became successful. Second, that's how I can do things, get things done, prepare for things to get them done. Second, today we are going online voting, but right now we have seen what has happened. Last year I decided to approve it, and I, as the council member, as the secretary, I'm the one who sat in all the meetings, pushing for the online voting. That's an innovation. That's what I'm speaking to, innovation. I did online voting, and that's one thing I can do. That's one thing, as if we can do change, we can make them happen. Another thing. I remember when I went back home as a secretary in Hollywood, my brother Charles Onyango sent me an email. Emmanuel, do you know what's happening? They have cancelled the John Campus bus and the Rogai bus is no longer there. He called me. I said to cut short my holiday to come back to Nazarene to defend my students. Why can't they cut the bus? Why can't they get the bus? I said, I will stay home for my holiday. Come back to Kenya. Come back to Nazarene. Bring back the bus. Though the bus came out with fares, but the bus was restored. The bus is there and they're going to push for a new bus, and from there in between, would you pay for the bus? And that I can show you to happen. We are dancing, and we are able to do things. Voting for Rusaka is voting for change. Voting for Rusaka is voting for success. Voting for Rusaka is voting for empowerment. Voting for Rusaka is voting for innovation. Thank you.
Thank you, Dave. You have taken all the credit you deserve, and clearly, from your manifestos, we see that you know everything that is happening in the school. So I would like to know, I would like you guys to tell me, what is the number one priority that you guys are going to implement, if elected president, are going to implement in the next 1 year? The number one priority, because you talked about swimming pools and everything that you talked about. So now what is the number one priority that if elected, you are going to implement, and how are you going to do that? We start with Charles.
Okay, to me these things seem to be weighty, all of them, but if I were to start, this issue of sports and clubs. A number of clubs have gone out in the sports, for example, handball group. I went to the FK, but what I saw there was really, it was not something good. You find that when we are there, when students are there, when it comes time to play games, they don't have proper uniform. I can remember they were trying to, after one player say, maybe it's come out that when he's removing the uniform, giving to the other one. Just imagine how kind of embarrassment where we have all different kinds of universities. Then another thing concerning the issue of food that nobody's given when you go out there. Chicken, for example, this thing you were leaving the campus at 7 and 6. It's packed at 4.
probably not in Kitaka in the PM. After 12 hours, surely it is something that is not nice. When I become a president, first people, these are things just new to me. It's not a matter of, they say that people are so much fun, like the swimming pool or like the bus. These are things to be implemented immediately. So the sports, every weekend, sports people, sportsmen and women have been going out. This is something to be immediately engaging the administration so that these things can be effective. So you told me what?
So for you, the issue of club is the part.
The issue of sports and club.
All right.
Yeah, I will deal with this so that we can start to move on.
As leaders, we need to be realistic. Say what things can be done. My number one priority is infrastructure, innovation. By that I mean, from the gate to canteen need to be paved. Need to have pavement there. That's my number one priority. Outside the gate, we need to have shades. I have my manifesto here. Install shades and resting seats in key areas like the bus bay and the sports fields. Infrastructure will be my number one priority. We can't Nazarene. Once entering the gate, there's nothing. Cleaners need to. My number is my first. Install shades in cities in areas like papers, sports, and make pavement here from gate to canteen. That's my number one priority. Elected president of the council. Empower students.
I'll also be when I was running for president of Africa as a leader of the country. But my number one priority, if not infrastructure, if not the sport, but the students. Their students are my priority. My priority is each and every one of you teachers right here. If I'm walking on a swimming pool, then I get a text. There's a student who needs help with the final. I go. If I'm in class, I get a text. There's a student who needs help with interview. I go. So my number one priority is the students of African American University.
Thank you very much. So I now have a specific question for you guys, and I'm going to ask the two guys at the extreme. So, it's concerning your manifestos. Please write them down so that when I finish asking the questions, you will now answer. Or you can memorize them if you want. So I will start with Emmanuel. In your manifesto, I've not seen anything about financial aid. Do you think the students need some financial aid? You know, some students can come, they don't have enough money to pay for their fees. So do you think we can have a certain fund from which we can get funds, like to pay for the school people, those who don't have enough money for the tuition, for the whole program? And if you think we need it, how are you going to go about the implementation with the school administration? And about Kitaka, sorry, I was just getting the middle, sorry. Charles, you said you are going to enact the constitution which will enable the students to be aware of their political rights and development. Knowing that Nazarene is a political institution, we don't have political things in here. Can you explain to us what is that, like political development?
I start?
Yes.
So I think what they're doing right now is this is political, purely political. But now the way they are doing it is not the way so aware of what the national or county are doing, but they're doing a different way so that as we continue holding the battles of Africa and the US. So this is politics.
Oh, you meant the debate?
Yes. Not debate. Politics is what we are exercising our rights to voting. This is politics.
All right. Thank you.
Financial. Yes, it can be done. How? Providing scholarship for students. It has already been implemented with our alumni scholarship funds. It's just a matter of pushing up and up scholarships. If students have excelled and doesn't have enough funds for him to continue to accept his stuff, provide for him a scholarship. It can happen. And that thing can happen easily.
No.
It can happen.
No.
By providing scholarships. Students apply for a scholarship if it's like fees, play sports. I guarantee we are giving out sports scholarship. He applied around enough funds to go out for the next semester. And he can be awarded scholarship for the entire semester.
So you mean there is no need to introduce a financial aid fund?
There is a need.
You said it's already there.
It's already there in terms of scholarships. But you get to know that not every student has that benefit.
Thank you. Thank
not
you.
Everyone gets those scholarships. Now we involve our students to apply and apply and apply. My brother Kelvin is not doing his exam because of that. Because he didn't finish to pay his money. Well, when he gets his funds, so it's really, really necessary to prevent that thing in campus.
So you are telling the students who are in need just to apply. The fund is already there.
The funds is already there.
Already.
Just need to apply.
Thank you.
Thank you.
My question is
both
my Charles. So Charles, you talked about providing enough area for both of us with their belongings. So previously, it is not a secret that the school intends to make money over the holidays by letting people stay in places like Crawford. And even when they go to us, they actually tell you that you cannot leave your belongings here because we intend to use the hostel to make money, that the school needs money. So exactly how do you intend to implement what you say if at all the school's number one priority is making money out of everything else? And if at all the school does not do that, then what are the repercussions? To Emmanuel, you said very categorically in your transport docket that without any further negotiation, the university should provide transport. So what is the plan? What is the process? And if at all it is not implemented, what do you intend to do? What if the school tells you that we cannot give you a bus? What do you intend to do?
I've seen some manifesto that we need to negotiate. It is not time for negotiation. It is time for the student to say we want this. It is time for the student to say we want our bus. I'm going to the question. We don't want negotiation for the bus. The bus must be provided. How? The how that question that we need as students, make a petition for it. We write a petition, sign signatures, the bus to provide it. It's a matter of unity. It's a matter of coming together as students, a matter of coming together as Nazarene students, and the bus will be provided.
Emmanuel, if I may cut you short, this proposal has been written times before, and what do you think that you're going to do? What extra is it that you're going to do? And you're not answering the question. What are the consequences of the school saying no? What will you do?
Ladies and gentlemen, if the school says no for the bus, I'm going to resign from the president. If I'm elected to the president and the university doesn't provide a bus, trust me, you are resign from the president and say, you are not working for the students, you are working for your own interest. It's a matter of putting the customer in front.
So Emmanuel, you want to go on
the better It's a matter of putting the customer in front. And putting a customer is satisfying his need. Once you not satisfy his need, me, I'm telling you, Student Nazare, if the bus is not coming, I will resign from the presidency.
You're going on the
airport. Excuse me. Can I please check?
Ladies and gentlemen, Rusaka is going on record as having said if there is no bus, he's going to resign. You, the students of Nazarene, have the right to hold him accountable to his
work. And we are going to demand votes to ensure the bus comes here, because if not, he'll resign.
Okay, thank you so much. I believe that. Let me start by saying, I believe that true leaders never desire to be successful. Because by doing that, for some people, you leave your people to judge the worst that they can die. Okay, let me
talk about that. I'll start about concerning the story of Jesus. Okay. Let me say this. Fellow students, you know that most of the time I've been doing some work at the facility department. Having been since I came to this school, and every class I've been working there since 2013. So, as I stand here before you, fellow students, I know how they move any other place to be located. It's not even a matter of administration, it's a matter of facility manager. It's the one who gets the, and it's the one, is there a roof? They contact you. That means I've already started with him all these things. It's just a matter of administration. If I present it for administration, they will ask you, do we have a place for like this room? You say, yes, we have. That's all. Thank you so much.
Okay, I'll ask you all this question. It's a simple question. What makes you better than your opponents? After Kitaka, what? Why are you not the other group?
Being asked by the students whether you have a session to ask them questions, then you will. We're waiting for the panel first to ask the questions, then you have a seat. So please do share.
Thank you very much for the opportunity. Sadly, we all have ambitions, we all have motive, we all have vision for us all that wants us to be the students. First of all, to start with, I have a team. I don't walk alone, I have a team. That clearly makes you better because we all know what it needs to take to be the school president. You can't be vice president if you don't have a vice president. It never happened. You know, I don't have my own selfish interest. I have a team, I work together, I can dedicate the work. Therefore, work.